Horizon Discovery reported unaudited preliminary results for the year ending in December 2014. The company has transformed from a private UK life sciences business to a publicly listed life sciences group with an international outlook, and it's been a busy year. The Cambridge-based firm supplies research tools to scientists working on genomics and the development of personalised medicines. Clients include major pharmaceutical, biotechnology and diagnostic companies, as well as leading academic research centres. Well, CEO and President Dr. Darrin Disley joins me now. Hello there, Darrin. Now, first results since listing on AIM. We're looking at 79% revenue increase, and products and services are up 99%. I mean, is this a sign of things to come?
Yes, I think it's part of the strategy from the IPO. So our services business is more mature. We've been offering services since we started. And through the acquisitions of Combinatorics and Sage, we've been able to now expand the range of services that we can offer from early stage drug discovery right the way through to clinical stage drug discovery. So our services business, you would expect us to focus on linking the value moving forward and driving margins into that. It's not a commodity type service. But the real investment from the IPO has gone into the product part of the business. How do we scale that predictable revenue stream, you know, smaller number of touch points to customers sold through the internet, and that's growing even faster. So as we move forward, this two-year investment trajectory we're on before transitioning to profit is focusing on how do we get more scale and more margin out of that vending machine-like product offering.
It has been an exciting growth story, hasn't it? You're talking about that vending machine product. I mean, that's hugely geared around innovation, and technology is fast changing. How tricky is it to keep up with that?
Indeed. Well, one of the key parts of our strategy is to be a scientific leader. We supply the picks and shovels to help people find gold, as in pharmaceutical drugs and the diagnostic tests that go with them. And we are experts at how you find the gold too. We're not just supplying the picks and shovels. So that's how we're able to get this leveraged upside of this £158 million of milestones and drug royalties without the cost of digging for gold. But the real change has been about being an innovator in gene editing. So when you think for the first 7 years, we were only able to create 700 of these patients in a test tube. Through technology innovation and the acquisition of Haplogen Genomics, we now can generate hundreds per month at 1/10 of the cost. So we've been able to stock that vending machine. If you look at FY14 results, 2,700 products. If you looked at us today, 16,500 products, only 5 months later.
That's your product line, but let's talk about investment, because you said that you're still on the lookout. You haven't finished your shopping spree. Yes. Have you got enough in the coffers to keep spending,
yes,
or are you going
to
go to market again?
4 year 14 cash was £18.5 million still left, and so clearly we've made three acquisitions within the £40 million gross that we raised, £37 million net, and we used equity. So we have that cash plus equity to go forward. If you look at what we've actually done with these acquisitions, we've built the breadth in our offering from DNA sequence right the way through to treatment. So moving forward, in licensing of products, specific products, for example, and if we were looking at M&A, it'd be about more depth into the P&L of these different areas. We'll be acquiring not just revenue, but profit too. So that would be a combination of equity and cash. And clearly we're looking out, depends on the types of companies that are available, as to whether we fund that out of current cash and equity, or whether we did come back to market, and we're keeping all options open.
In terms of building your portfolio and looking at what you need, what synergies you're after, I'm interested to know where you think you could be maybe a little bit more nimble, and what you could gain from linking up or buying someone else.
Thinking
about the consortium that you're part of that got the government grant, a team of companies that presumably all bring something different to the table.
Yep. There's an example of scientific leadership and innovation. It's opening up a new area of business for us that wasn't even really represented in our IPO prospectus, and that's the ability to engineer cell lines that are as manufacturing engines. Most drugs now are biological materials, not chemicals, and so cells are used to produce those, just like much like a yeast is used to ferment beer. You grow cells very rapidly and they produce drug. And that's innovation with those consortia enable us to learn more, but also come out of that with new products, and those products drive new revenue, new milestones. So I think that's one area, you know, of innovation. Where we could be more nimble, I think, in terms of looking at other companies that might fit with us, we're looking for things, you know, if you looked at something that, you know, products is a big focus for us, so clearly a products business in licensing either individual product lines or acquiring companies to fill that vending machine out, preferably with adjacent markets, so you address a broader array of customers or link the products together to create new products, whether they be our products or third-party innovation products. We now have this baseline vending machine that could link up with antibody companies, to link up with enzyme companies, so you could link and create third-party products that could be sold broadly.
So you're connecting the dots for a lot of people. Yes. Are there others out there doing it? I'd like to know where you see yourself in terms of the competition.
Yeah, I think we have an incredibly favourable competitive landscape. I've been in the industry for, you know, 20 years, and I've never seen a favourable landscape like this. Think how fast things moved. When Horizon started, only 300 of these genetically defined cell lines in the history of science had been engineered. And genome sequencing was $10 million per sequence. It's suddenly gone to sub-$1,000 for a sequence in 8 years. And this ability to engineer the genome, there's been very few people doing it. So Horizon, I think, is really in a primary strong position with a very strong balance sheet of installed customer base. And most of our competitors, if you think the last 2 years, the two competitors we would have considered in the research tool space to be our biggest competitors, Selectus is now a therapeutic company listing on NASDAQ a few weeks ago, and Sigma Aldrich Gene Editing, Sage Labs, we acquired last year. So we see a very competitive advantage for us in the marketplace right now.
It's not just, though, about being in the right place at the right time. There's a complex strategy behind all of this.
It is. You know, I'm a big cricket fan, and Richie Beno, one of my heroes, died this week, and he had a famous quote, you know, before you go in to do something like start a business or play professional sport. He said, it's 90% luck and 10% extreme talent, but don't try it without the extreme talent.
And you presumably are that extreme talent.
I believe
Darrin,
so.
It's been a pleasure talking to you. Thank you.
No worries. Thank you.